So my name is Haotian Wu. A lot of people just call me Howie. We're here at UMass Amherst. We are in Dr. Rick Pilsner's lab here, called the Environmental Epigenetics Lab, and we are in the Department of Environmental Health Sciences under the School of Public Health. So our focus is to look at sort of like inheritance, how the environment around us affect our inheritance. And we do it by looking at epigenetics and how it affects reproduction. To make an analogy, it's sort of like Legos. I think of it like Legos. You can have this big box of Lego blocks. Think of that as like the DNA, and then and our genetic sequences, and then you can have instructions on top of it. So you can think of epigenetics as this layer of guidebooks. So you, when you get given different books, different instructions, you can build different things from it. So each of us here are built a little bit differently, and we have a little bit different epigenetics. We have a little bit different genetics too, but we're really interested in how this layer of information, but not the actual DNA sequence itself, affects inheritance and reproduction and stuff like that. I took a really convoluted way here, and I fell sort of backwards into this place. I did my undergrad at University of Ottawa in Canada in biomedical sciences. I had a minor in history because I was interested in it, but mainly I wanted to be a doctor at the time. In about my third and fourth year of college, I really thought about it, and I started working in a hospital, and I realized that I didn't really want that. I didn't really think that was the right way for me, so I started looking for grad school. UMass fortunately accepted me for the epidemiology program, so I spent 2 years there, and it was in the last semester that I met Dr. Pilsner in one of his classes, and we started talking, and we realized I was a lot more interested in his type of research, where I could do a little bit more bench science, like I was doing in undergrad. I could do a lot of epidemiology stuff on the computers, bioinformatics, stuff like that. So I thought it was really exciting, and it was a perfect fit for me. It's really fascinating because, you know, we realize that genetics is important, it's crucial, but epigenetics plays a huge role in not only disease, but also think about everyday normal things. How does your eye cell know how it's an eye cell? Epigenetics, it provides this layer of instructions and more, and that's what's so fascinating about it. So sort of immediate pressing needs on the reproduction side is to hopefully identifying things that could lead us to identify why people are infertile, for example, why sperms are bad, why eggs are bad. But long term, you know, if there's one thing in our field is that we want to not only see how these environmental chemicals can affect our generation, so us as adults and children and our offspring, but also there are people thinking that cancer can be related to genetics. There's science with other diseases like that, obesity and diabetes and stuff like that. So when we talk about those things and we're talking about child development and epigenetics and even adults, hopefully we're able to change that. We're able to put people on corrective therapeutic measures and, you know, as a way of treating them or curing them, hopefully.
If we really have a small piece of DNA, we would ideally like to get more of a special section than we want. So right now, we're just confirming that we have no DNA in our RNA sample. So it means that generally the experiment worked and these results are believable.
Yeah, so I would say that you should find your field first. You can't, now, you know, as somebody younger, you know, it may be unrealistic for somebody, you know, who's 18 years old when they go into college, or another milestone is, you know, 21, 22, 23 when you graduate college to be making these choices. But you really need to be able to find your field, find what you're comfortable with, and find what you're good at. Because if you don't find the right field for you, you're going to be miserable, and chances are you might not even finish the program. And even if you do, are you going to want to be in this field this whole time? So you really need to go and experience all sorts of different things in order to find something that you like. And you can, and I don't think there's a very good way to do this. You sort of just have to throw darts at it until it gets closer. You take a shot here, it doesn't work. Okay, let's still take a shot at someone completely random. So if you just go out there and experience all the different fields that you might be interested in, you will eventually, hopefully, find one that you really like. And that's the one that you would want. So I think my biggest advice is find the field for you, and everything will become easier.